Well, let's actually go with Floki. We'll see what happens there. Some shenanigans, definitely. Yeah, look at him, he's so happy to see us. Maybe I should have read that, right? Wait a minute. Oh, he might just be a, what? He might just be a companion. Why is this harder than it should be? Which one of them is a leader? Not the companion. Good question. Oh god. I have to do this the manual way. Actually, we got some money. We can actually see if... we can get the two-handed axe. And yeah, we can get the simple one. It's good as any. Let's grab more throwing weapons, though. For the horseman javelins. There we go. Later, I'm gonna get rid of the throwing weapons since we are gonna be speedier without them. Wait a minute, she's not in the same clan. No, I was looking at the wrong. Wait, was I? I may have looked at the wrong thing. Oh, let's join him, why not? He's definitely not gonna run into a whole bunch of enemies and get wrecked. Definitely. This was a good idea, but kind of freaking annoying that you need to like place it all the time. He was going to besiege something, but he changed his mind apparently. Oh right, he's not the army leader, never mind. Let's see if I can actually win a tournament. I'm not sure if I'm gonna be able to hit someone that small, actually. You knew that height was a disadvantage, right? Okay, there we go. Maybe better if I get on a horse, to be honest. Just for this bit. Yeah, that's Ragnar. Of course it is, and I killed him. Nice. But if you do really want like a realistic game, that you do want to get a realistic battle combat modifier thing, really does make like, you know, fully armored units like take zero damage from unarmored ones. Like, you know, like slashing at the fully armored enemy is gonna do fuck all, which, you know, should be like that. Bash, and you still can get the hit in. Like, he's higher tier, so you can't really, like, get a hit in on him with the mod. Even when the combat is on normal. What was it? Normal? Yeah, normal. And I was wondering why I couldn't get a hit in when I played the mod yesterday. Yeah, what? Apparently I threw all my weapons. Look at this, a Batanian hero. Let's see how many blocks he makes. Okay, come on. Oh, the followers, man. Got no posture again. If the two-handers are always like easier to beat, kind of. I think this is the guy that wrecked me in the arena as well. Fuck you, there you go. Hate spearmen. Especially when the AI is playing with them, like basically the only way to get the hit in is to wait for them to poke and hope to god they don't hit you. Hey Ryan, what's up? Like, ooh, what am I gonna do? Oh. I'm gonna get wrecked by a watchman. Really wish these bashes and kicks did like a little bit more stun. Ah, oh, goddamn. Oh, the music is not from a mod, it's Assassin's Creed Valhalla soundtrack, Ancestor's Legacy soundtrack, and Thrones of Britannia, Total War soundtrack. So all three of those mixed in together. I think I'm gonna add some like more games with soundtracks in, or like soundtracks for more games when I think of them. Okay, let's swing speed in one hand with axes and maces. There was a mod for this game that added in Realm Total War music, but it's not around anymore. And damage with two-handed axes and two-handed maces. Yeah. I just, you know, grabbed all the soundtracks and put them together. I do have a, like, I wonder what, like, where am I gonna get the soundtrack for, well, the background music for Tessogin mod playthrough when I do one. It, you know, it's Japanese samurai and all that. Guess Shogun Total War 2 might be an idea. Shogun Total War, maybe even Ghost of Tsushima. That might have a pretty decent, of course it has a decent soundtrack. It's a pretty good game. Yeah, I got to think of it like a couple more, actually. Oh, if we're going to a siege, what? Every time on a horse. Question now is gonna be if the game is gonna crash. If the game crashes with this mod, like these mods I have. If you're in the infantry group when a siege is initiated, for some reason. Any hobbies besides gaming? Streaming, right? It's a hobby. Well, my life is always into computers. I do like building computers and all that. Always was good with these things. Oh god. Why did I get the worst weapon for the... Oh shit. Worst... Oh, oh, that looks so cool. I mean, I do mine cryptocurrency, I don't trade it. Maybe you could call that, oh god, it's an archer. Call that, hobby. I probably can't, it's still on the computer. I don't really have that much time for hobbies, to be honest. You know, college and all that. And gaming, streaming. We're supposed to train them, not kill them. Which kind of, like, you need them to block. Otherwise you kill them too fast. They might kill me too fast, to be honest. Come on, just keep blocking. Yeah, I'm gonna turn on the UI for this, so we can actually see once the train, how far we got in. Yeah, we only 190, we need 1,000 in training. Finish this, like, mini quest. This should be the, like, highest. This is what we're going for with the berserker equipment. You know, like, see how the higher tiers, like, block almost all hits on normal difficulty. That's what the mod changes around. I was thinking, also for the music, I was thinking of grabbing the music from, I think you can find, oh goddamn. Yeah, apparently I can't click off without the game resuming. There's a creation guy that makes a lot of good Celtic Nordic like music. Philip Lachkovich, I guess you'd call him. You can find him on YouTube, he has some pretty good music. But I was like messing about with the, like getting the mods to work, so I didn't have time to contact him, see if I can use his music. I'll post a link into the chat if you want to check him out. Oh shit. And are you the Hammer of Thor? Are you? Literally one shots me. Sword is a bit faster than the hammer, thankfully. I do like the Batanian swords, like the way he switches the shoulder, like depending on which they attack direction you want to go with. Faints, man. I ain't used to this. I'm not playing chivalry too. Okay. Oh, there we go. This guy, post the link in the chat if you want to check out some, you know, his music is pretty good. Considering he does it all on his own. I guess it's gonna be time to find out if all my testing today was worth it. I like spent like, well, yesterday and today I spent like maybe like 4 or 5 hours on like getting the game or getting, you know, testing out if the game's gonna crash again or not, or why it crashes with these mods. So we're about to find out. These trusties renegades are all over the place. Give me a second. Can I go take a piss? Well, I can leave this on, right? I can go take a piss. Thank you. Okay, so I see the siege didn't go through, as per usual in this game. We're in a battle which we're probably gonna lose. And we're the... Oh, God. And we're the attacker. And they have the archer advantage as well. Ain't gonna go well, that's for sure. Got 14 throwing spears, though. You do have a lot of cav, and I don't really have a fast horse so I can actually catch up to him. Motherfucker. God, you're so inaccurate when you're low. Never mind. There I go. Well, let's wait in reserves, see what happens. Yeah, another defeat. As I suspected. At least you yourself are not like at war with these factions. You're not gonna get wrecked by the enemy like that. A fucking 5 looters are in my way. Okay, I guess let's find someone else to join again. Is she out and about? Probably. We don't really need it. Yeah, faster horse. Yeah, let's get a faster horse. Yeah, sure, why not? Why not? An upgrade is an upgrade, after all. That. Did you want to join the same army? Not even like a... Or the same lord, not even like a, the same clan. So you can actually like... You know, be in the... same tier of troops. I'll still be on a horse though. Abandon the party, really, because you're gonna lose a shit ton of relations and you're gonna be like a known criminal to the faction. Although you can actually go in and like pay off the fact, you know, pay them off so you're not hated by everyone. Well, hated, but you still get hated by most of the faction lords for some reason. Even they don't even know your name or anything, which kind of sucks. I'm curious to try the lock-on system, but it's gonna get me killed probably. Naval being able to lock on to enemies while using melee. What? I feel that's gonna get me killed. Unfortunately, I didn't notice that the Sturgians or the Nordics are the weakest, I'd say, faction. At least at the beginning here. From what I play tested so far, there's... just get wrecked, more or less. Hey, come on. Catch him! There we go. So the game still, like, lets you... counts you as a different party, even though you're supposed to be in the army of Lagertha. Which I think may cause crashes here and there. There they are. Run away, horsey. Don't turn towards me, come on. Ain't fair. Oh god. I like how they just like, oh, we're going this way. Then they immediately aggro onto you and you're dead. Let's get these medicine working. No, you're an ape. That serves me right. I was sitting there throwing stuff at them, thinking they're not gonna turn around and attack me, right? AI ain't that oblivious. Not fighting bandits. You do see the AI actually pick up a lot of companions, though. Like, look at the... I can't pronounce his name, but look on the left. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8. Actually, 8 companions. Well, that might be a problem, actually. I guess companions don't die as easily as normal troops, but still, like... I don't think the AI knows how to deal with it, to be honest. Situation in Ukraine. I think it's America and Russia. Having a chest bump context. Oh, look who's better. Oh, look, you know. Core chain, буквально. Ко що за коче прокусили, ко що кучил проконас, одес і так ось все остало. There's not much to think about it, actually. I mean, Europe is like, nothing's gonna happen, but US wants a war, so I mean. I don't think anything is gonna happen though. Although, like, you gotta really look at the facts, like, NATO is there as, like, a opposition bloc to Soviet Union. Soviet Union is no more. and they keep getting nations like right next to the Russia's border into NATO and placing defenses against Russia right on their border. But I mean, quote unquote defenses. So, I mean, I'd see that as it's like Russia placing, getting like into a coalition with Mexico and I guess Canada and placing a runaway, what are you doing? And placing a missile systems and all that on their American's border. I mean, same thing, really. Would America stand for that? Probably not. But the fact that it's always on the news, you notice like the, you know, the shit show that is happening in Ukraine, it's happening for the last like, what, 10, well, maybe not 10 years, but some like a really long time at this point. And for some reason, you know, it was on the news for a year, then we heard nothing about Ukraine, even though the conflict is still on for like half a decade. And now we start hearing about it again. Wonder why. Like, why are they, like, you know, why do they have a spotlight on that? What the hell else is happening? You got to take, you know, you got to ask that question. Because, you know, these problems in Ukraine is, like, nothing new. It's been with, like, I think for the last 7 years, something like that. I can't remember actually when it started. Al što mi rekli nisu čisto posla, brate. Something fishy is going on. Nobody knows what exactly. They're never gonna tell us. By us, I mean the general public. We're never gonna know what the fuck's on and why is everything happening. The only thing we can do is like acknowledge that, that something is fucking fishy and they're doing something over there. Or like I said, they're like getting a spotlight on that. To cover up something else or like make us not notice something else they're doing. I mean, you have America who's more interested in Ukrainian sovereignty now than their own, which is fucking abysmal, but still. It's a thing. And plus, we have an America that's not at war for the first time in, well, since the United States exists. So, something new for them. Like, ooh, we're not at war. What the fuck are we gonna do? Have to look at that. Look at it that way as well. For the first time in what, 300 years, 400 years? Well, why can't I remember the date America was? The Independence War happened, and they got the states for them. Or they. What's the word? Oh goddamn English. When America got their independence, I can't remember the year for it. Then again, the Americans don't know shit about history, so why should I know about shit about their histories? Right? Oh no, I wanted to participate. Oh goddamn it. although we can't really say that they're not at war. They're still... And they still, like, they're not still in Syria, but they're, like, have drones all over the place. I mean, I could... Maybe you can say they're not at war, but not really. I mean, we'll see what happens. I mean, everyone is ignoring the fact that living necessities becoming more expensive by the day. Everyone's ignoring that. Well, not ignoring that, but no one's talking about it as much as we should. Inflation. Bread and, well, even oil. Bread, gasoline, everything is being... The price of everything is going up. Which doesn't bother the elites, of course. And this is gonna bother us. The middle class, well, middle class, working class, whatever you wanna call us. The average. It's enough any country. Well, most countries. You motherfuckers, you killed my horse. They're gonna kill me now. Yep. Well, you took your sweet time getting here. Sturgia is too weak like, and besiege that and not get wrecked by their armies. Because I got the Philstacks mod on, definitely the amount of land a faction has is definitely gonna impact how much army or troops they're gonna have, since they recruit like a player. They actually need to go to a village and a town to recruit. Get anyone else? Right, let's check any alliances. Yet. Okay, the Northern Empires, they're only war at one with one faction. No alliances yet though. Oh, it's probably you know, alliances in total war. Yeah, you have an alliance, but you never really, like, see your ally help you in any way in battle. Like, you know, when you actually fight. It's like, yeah, look at that. Oh, we're fucking screwed. Yup. Huh? That guy fucked up. Plus, there's a problem with, like, yeah, you've seen the problems, like Denmark, Netherlands, and some other nations have problem with, you know, the marketplaces just being empty, no food in them, because there's a lack of truck drivers and all that, and the supply chain as a whole has got wrecked. I mean, getting vaccinated and all that. Sure is nice, but it's gonna be a lot nicer to have something to eat. It's gonna be a big problem if you have nothing to eat, not like if you're not vaccinated or you get COVID. Most people survive it. You have a Mac. I think the GPU prices are gonna drop after this, you know, in the summer if Ethereum goes proof of stake. So you should be able to find like a decent GPU. And CPUs are still pretty cheap. It seems like the new Intel and AMD ones are gonna be freaking epic when it comes to performance as well. So you might like wanna save up one of those, maybe like wait for the Intel 13 generation, whatever it's gonna call, Raptor Lake or something like that. Grab one of those or the new AMD ones. Like even if you get the like lower, wait a minute, those are my guys. Like the i3s and i5s. They're still pretty fucking good if you're only gonna play the games. Oh no, just play the games. It's sad, but I know what my... I must spend 3,000 euros or dollars on an RTX 3090, right? Is that it? Or do you need to sell your Mac? Run away, you fool! Okay, we're actually gonna make it. Not if he runs into a fucking sea, that is. No, not that way, not that way, not... Oh. Is he gonna be smart enough to run away? Kind of. I was actually like, I was thinking about getting one of the 12th gen CPUs from Intel, but like I was like looking at the, you know, listings on the internet for DDR5, and there were none on like two days ago, I think. DDR5 appeared on our stores. So, and it's not as expensive as I thought it was gonna be, honestly. Although, like, you know, the speeds are pretty low. Oh, fuck. Worst faction ever. Yeah. Maybe I could increase the battle sizes actually a little bit. Why don't we have a shield wall in front? This is so odd. Why are they spread out? Hello. Oh god, right. Oh, that's a nice hit. Okay, there we go. That's how it's done, boys. Like, get up in their ass and throw an axe at them. There we go. We got more javelins. Watch out to net so I don't get lanced or even poked, because we're gonna die in one hit more or less at these speeds. Come on. There we go. I don't know why I'm chasing these, I can't catch up to them. He survived that, really? I can never get the range on these, right, to be honest. Yeah, sure, go melee our infantry. That's gonna go well for you. How the fuck am I missing all these? Okay, now this decide to shoot. I saw it and I didn't react fast enough. Well, not like I had a shield or anything. But that was a lance. Okay, this might be actually smart, like spread out and attack the enemy so the less troops get hit. The Valenians do sure have a lot of these crossbowmen. And sharpshooters. Under the tracker. Does he track? Well, it's not gonna matter. There's a whole lot of enemies on our ass. This is gonna be a little bit better. Why did you go that way? Fucking morons. Gathers have no more use for you and aren't in a murderous mood, so they'll let you go. Oh, how nice of them. I do have deaths enabled. I wonder if that's gonna actually, like, screw me up at some point. Get a disease or a limp or something. I'm not sure if that's a thing, but would be freaking neat. Would be freaking cool. He's a prisoner still? What about you? He's a prisoner as well. No, she leads, yeah, she definitely leads an army, look at her. Do you lead an army? Wait, what? Apparently she does, what? I'm confused. She doesn't lead an army. Read that. Maybe not. Look at little Bjorn. She looks like she leads an army. Him as well. For some reason, I can't remember what the name of the of Ragnar's brother in the show as for some reason. Oh, Rollo, right, Rollo. He rolled down a hill. I'll see if he can get the pass a horse. Not really. Let's get an upgrade though. Better axe. Wait a minute, those are one-handed. Right, let's get a better axe. Fuck the horse. We don't need a horse. We're gonna be on foot anyway. Maybe not. Look at the prices on these. Priced. Okay, maybe we are getting some better armor for the horse. Look at these mean motherfuckers behind you. Wait a minute. Where the fuck am I, a Valkyrie? What? What? That was weird. Yeah, just give me a woman's body. I'm gonna be fine with that. Actually, if you do go that route, I think the Valkyries get the better armor. And they get the super fucking fast horse as well. Oh god. You do wanna like have a shield on our backs. You know, it looks kind of better than just not having one. But the problem with that is one of the perks actually like makes you move faster if you have nothing else equipped. No like throwing weapons or a shield equipped. That's kind of disappointing. And I hit the Valkyrie. Oh god then. I still have zero clue which ones are the enemies here. Never mind. This would be the smart thing to do, right? Yeah, but we ain't scared. The fact that they go up and pick up the arrows that are on fire. Okay, that like breaks the realistics of it a little bit. Well, an arrow stuck in the ground is surely not straight anymore, right? Die, you pig! There's more. What? Oh, cavalry. Of course. It might take a while to like get up to the higher tier I want. Just because the AI just has some, makes some stupid freaking decisions. Not that I really need to like wait till we get to the highest tier, honestly. It's a good and easy way to level, like, you level up the skills though. Do things like this, right? Just keep the javelins in for the mop-ups. Once they start running away. Okay, let's put a point into medicine. Right, do I have to ask to become the medic? Another army is forming. We're gonna get wrecked if we go to the... Yeah, that over there. Again. The Valandians are there at war. That's me. See that? The game still considers you a faction, even while you're a soldier.